Malta. The island in the sun put on its sunniest face to welcome its queen. And what an affectionate welcome it was. Her Majesty, accompanied by the Duke of Edinburgh, was making her first state visit to the island since Malta attained independence a little over 3 years ago. Prime Minister Dr. Borg, Olivier, presented his address of welcome to Her Majesty at the palace in Valetta. Then it was on to a sumptuous banquet. The Queen was accompanied by the Governor General Sir Maurice Dorman. It was very obvious the immense warmth the islanders had for the Queen. And the banquet, held in the armoury of the Valetta Palace, was a sparkling, happy occasion. The following day was the high point of Her Majesty's visit to Malta. In the throne room of the Maltese Parliament, the Queen exercised her constitutional right and set the wheels of Maltese government in motion. In her speech from the throne, the Queen said the Maltese government would do everything it could to cushion the impact of the rundown of British forces in Malta. Retraining and alternative employment would be provided for those affected. It was in the happiest of moods that the people of Malta greeted their Queen as she left the Parliament building. It has been 13 years since Her Majesty was last in Malta. Now she had returned bringing good news. A happy day for the island. Now it was the turn of Malta's youth to show how very much the Queen meant to them. 22,000 youngsters gathered in Independence Square. On their behalf, presents were handed to Her Majesty for her family. The youth of Malta showed their enthusiasm in no uncertain way. The Queen and her husband had given assurance of a sound future for the younger generation in their homeland. Their tomorrows were secure, and the faith of her Maltese subjects was even more loyal to the crown. It was a great personal triumph for Her Majesty. Before she left the youth rally, the Queen told the children to work together when they grew up and to keep Malta a lovely and happy place.